big win.
So we had them here when they got first place in state. Then you went to nationals, which where were they?
They were in Portland, Maine.
Portland, Maine. By the way, this is Griffin and Ty. Am I saying that right?
Yes.
Okay, good. I want to make sure I got your names right. Now, there's a third person who couldn't make it. Mm-hmm. But you guys, you found out about this from your dad, and you decided, hey, let's enter this contest. Did you ever think that you were going to get all the way to nationals?
Nope.
No, and then here you guys are. And what place did you come in at nationals?
We came in second place.
Second place? That's awesome. So how does this work? You guys are kind of going to give us a little demonstration.
Yeah, so we first start out when we're building our bridges. We build each side of the bridge.
Okay.
And then we put them together with these members.
That's
the
winning bridge right there, right?
Yeah, this is the national bridge.
Okay, and then do they test it with weight?
Yeah.
Yeah, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, and so Ty, your dad is over here, who I know as Mr. Hackett, because he used to work at Laguna Creek High School. Shout out to the EGUSD. Mr. Hackett, I can't call you anything else. I'm sorry.
It's Dave.
It's Dave. Okay, I wouldn't even have known your first name. Dave, what do we do with the bridge?
So we tested them in a couple of ways. One, they start by doing it on the computer.
Okay.
So they do a process on a program called ModelSmart 3D. And then we came up with an idea, well, we should actually test a real bridge. So we came up with the kitchen stools, and we put a bucket, and we hung it underneath the bottom of the bridge, and we just pour it with water.
Okay.
And so the water will eventually be heavy enough to break the bridge, and we put it on our bathroom scale.
Okay.
So we would know what designs are good and what's not so good.
When they go to the competition, what do you guys do? You bring the bridge in, and then they test it? Do they do something where they put, like, weights on it, or what do they do at the actual competition?
Yeah, so there's a machine kind of that they use. So they have a block that's stretched through the bridge.
Okay.
So it goes kind of like this.
So they have like a real scientific way of testing it, but you guys needed a way to test it at home because you don't have that.
Right.
So we're going to break this?
Yeah. Well,
how long did it take you to make this?
That was our California winning bridge.
Yeah, that was the one that won at state.
Yeah.
So and you're willing to break it on our show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's already a little bit broken.
Oh, it is? So, okay.
It's got to crack. So as soon as it cracks, they call it. So.
How do you transport this to Portland, Maine? Go ahead and do that, Ms. Hackett, and then you tell us how you transport it.
All right. So I'll add the water and.
Okay. Oh, it's doing pretty good. Oh, I see. Okay.
Got a little bit of a mess, but
now that shows that it's doing pretty good. Was that good?
Well,
you want it to last a little longer.
Right. So this, I'll weigh how much it carried, but Ty, why don't you tell them how much yours actually carried at the national competition?
So at the national competition, where this bridge held 68 pounds.
Okay.
And this bridge only weighed 2 grams heavier than the one at the state competition.
Okay, now
so
this is really cool.
Way more efficient.
And so what are you thinking for your guys? You guys are in middle school, so future career maybe in engineering?
Yeah, it's definitely a possibility for me because
when
I first got into this project, I was kind of interested in engineering, but I didn't know much about it, and now I'm really interested in it.
Okay, that's great. You guys have this stuff just laying all over your house?
Yeah,
and then next year competition, you're going to do it again?
Hopefully,
and do they have this in high school, too?
Yes.
Okay, you guys are getting a leg up. Second place. Next year, we're going to have you back here. First place.
Okay? Hopefully.
Number one. Thank you, guys, for coming here.
Yeah.
Your dad, by the way, was a great science teacher. Very fun. I had to dissect a frog in his class, and I did not want to do that. And he was very nice about helping us. So, just so you know, you got to really appreciate him. Griffin, I might know your parents. I don't know. Cody?
I feel like we just went through.